Well, I'm Queen Mother.
Hi, Queen Mother.
Dr. Delois Blakely. I'm the Community Mayor of Harlem and the Ambassador of Goodwill to Africa. And I am here to support the young people. Occupy Wall Street, occupy the hood, occupy the museums, occupy 477, occupy the streets, occupy everywhere we must occupy for change. So
Queen
Mother is here to support the young people. Well, basically, on the second day of Occupy Wall Street, I came to Wall Street to see what the young people's concerns were. And I'm glad I did, because I have worked with young people for 50 years all over the world. I've been involved with the United Nations and agitating for the last 40-some years. And as I traveled the world, and then when you think of Egypt, the young people rise up there, and concerns they had for change. And then with the young people here in the United States, took a strong position also to make a stand for change, to reform and what they could do. And that is a noble act for any change in a society. And they took that stance. And I came down the second day, and as I wandered around in the park that has been designated for what they use, they were not just concerned about one park. They was running around everywhere. They used to do their little running. So they may start at Zucotti Park down here, but then Liberty Park is called also. They would go other places. And at that time, they was just doing what they thought they should do. And so I remembered when I asked them, where's the black children? Where's the black children? I'm seeing so many white young people. And they came from all over the country. And many communities, because of their language, some was from the Deep South. And then I watched their clothing that they were wearing. And they wore all types of clothes, which also give you some indication where they came from in the Deep South and around the United States. And as I talked to them about my concern and saying, do you know that my ancestors were sold on Wall Street? And they said to me, Queen Mother, what are you saying? So I began to tell them the story about the slave trade that took place, that my ancestors were sold as a commodity. Their bodies were sold. And the first commodity, they must deal with this. As I said to the young people, I want them to deal with that issue. And as I brought that issue before the General Assembly, in the beginning, I did not see the big GA. It started like people took the liberty and spoke, and then they began to organize themselves in a format that they organized the General Assembly. And at the General Assembly, I was able to talk about issues, concerns that I had as an elder. And I just cared a lot for my check. Because whatever I said, it was echoed to the group. So that means that everyone heard what you had to say. And that was very important to me as an elder. And that was done. And with that, I respected the young people, and I kept coming down to Wall Street to discuss many of the issues and many of the concerns, what was happening. And with that, the young people began to listen to me as I talked about plan of action. I live in the hood. I occupy Harlem. We needed heat and hot water for the winter. And the predatory lenders and mortgage fraud was trying to take a building from me and other senior citizens and handicapped in Harlem. And I told the young people about this issue. They came to Harlem and sit in until we receive a new boiler from the city of New York, so we would not freeze to death in a property in Harlem. them and say in communities they must move toward plans of action for change. And that was the first change that they made, which we call now Occupy 477. That is what it's called now, Occupy 477. So with us doing Occupy 477, this has been important. They can look now at best practices that they have created in low-income communities. There's a low-income housing, and where the young people came, they sit in, they stay there until there was a change that happened. That is a movement when you can make a difference in the lives of others who cannot rally for themselves. The handicapped person cannot march for themselves, cannot articulate for themselves. They cannot confront the powers to be. The poor and the powerless need a voice. And these young people, highly educated, most of them, coming from strategic up communities, and for them to come together as a group and concern about the 99%, that is something to be reckoned with. So I come to support them. I must come support them. I must support them. Look at them today, in the crowd that you see today. Majority of the children that are marching, of young people, are basically white young people. Just look at what's going on. You see it for yourself. It's not something we have to discuss and talk about. We talk about what is going on. This is the reality. And it's good that they want to deal with also inclusion. Because what they did, they included me about the middle class passage of the transatlantic ocean of the slave trade. They included me. They listened to me as an elder. They listened to me and began to move toward a plan of action. Talking is one thing, but a plan of action is something entirely different. If we're talking about a plan of action, that they continue to articulate the issues of the day for change.